in the previous class we have discussed parts of the plant. Just I would like to recall it by showing the video.
Plant parts.
Do you know the parts of plants? The parts of plants, the parts of plants. Do you know the parts of plants that make them grow and grow? The roots, they hold the plant in place, the plant in place, the plant in place. The roots, they hold the plant in place, soak up food and water too. Grow and grow. The stem moves water up the plant, up the plant, up the plant. The stem moves water up the plant, bring water to the leaves. The leaves soak up the rays of the sun, the rays of the sun, the rays of the sun. The leaves soak up the rays of the sun and help the plant make food.
Let us discuss types of plants. Based on their size and kinds of stem, they have divided into following types. That is, trees, shrubs, herbs, climbers and creepers. What do you mean by trees, children? Tall and big plants are called trees. Tall and big plants are called trees. They have one main heart and woody stem, that is called trunk. Okay? Examples: mango tree, neem tree and coconut tree. Let us know about shrubs. What are shrubs? Small and bushy plants are called shrubs. Bushy means grow thickly with lot of leaves. That is called bushy. Okay? Shrubs means they have small and bushy plants. They are called shrubs. Example, hibiscus, rose and cotton plant, etc. What do you mean by herbs? Very small plants are called herbs. Very small plants are called herbs. They are soft and they have green stem. Okay? Examples, mint, coriander and grasses and some water plants are considered as herbs. Next, climbers. Some plants have weak stems, so they cannot grow straight. They can't stand erect. Erect means straight. So they need the support of other plant or wall or a stick to grow straight. Those plants are called climbers. Example, money plant, grapevine, etc. Next, creepers. Plants like watermelon, pumpkin and muskmelon, they grow along the ground because even they also have weak stem. Example, watermelon, pumpkin and muskmelon. Those plants are called creepers and these creepers have heavy fruit, is it not? Yes. Next, useful plants. Dear children, plants play very important role in our daily lives. They will be helpful to us in many ways. How they are helpful to us, let us see. Plants give us food grains. What are food grains, children? Pulses and cereals. Pulses like beans, peas and grams. Okay? And cereals like wheat and rice. Those we use as a food. Is it not? Yes. Next, plants give us spices. We get many types of spices. To make our food tasty, we have to add spices to our food. Is it not? Yes. That is cumin seeds, black pepper. Is it not? Yes. Plants give us Fibers are used for making the clothes. We get cotton fiber from the cotton plant and jute fiber from the jute plant. Next, plants give us oil. Oil is obtained from the seeds of some plants, that is groundnut, coconut and sunflower. Oil is used for cooking and oil is used for making the shampoos. Is it not? Yes. We get perfumes from the plant. We get perfume from the smelling flowers of the plants, that is jasmine, lily, rose and lavender. Is it not? Yes. We get medicines from the plants. Plants such as neem, tulsi, turmeric. Is it not? When you have cough and cold, you have to eat tulsi leaves. It keeps us stay healthy. Is it not? Yes. Next, we get rubber, gum and paper. We get paper from the bamboo plant. It is used for painting houses. And we get the coffee and wood. We get tea leaves from the tea plant. And plant give us wood. Wood is used for making furniture, boards and crafts. And wood is used for used as a fuel for burning. We get sugar from the sugarcane plant. Plants provide shelter to many birds and animals. Birds build nests in the trees. Plants keep the air clean. We need air to breathe. Is it not, children? Yes. So, instead of cutting the trees, we have to grow more and more plants and make our surrounding look beautiful. Is it not? Yes. I hope you have enjoyed today's class. Thank you.